Start.
Yes, sir. Good evening, everyone. I'm Malavika Anandar, the HR manager at Ecruz Aviation Private Limited. I'll be talking to you about the different types of jobs in the international airports. So to begin with, we'll be dealing with the 10 different kinds of positions that are available in the airport, which is flight attendant, concessionaire, air traffic controller, airport engineer, airport planner, TSA or TSO airport security members, air marshal, airframe or power plant mechanics, baggage handlers, and airline pilots. First of all, we'll be dealing with flight attendants. So from the moment they welcome you at the gate through the duration of your flight, few people are more important to your flight experience than flight attendants. They spend long hours on their feet. They serve passengers, they work to keep the plane clean, and they do all of this with a smile on their face. The last part, significantly the smile part on your face while you're doing all these difficult tasks, is pretty difficult. So after all, flight attendants often have to deal with angry or difficult passengers, to say nothing of the harassment faced by female attendants in particular. That said, flight attendants do enjoy perks, like being able to travel the world, health benefits that vary from airline to airline, and also given how much time they have to put up with the tasks that have been allotted, $39,000 might seem a bit low, but at least it's better than the other service based positions that are offered. Next, let's go to the concessionaire. So if you've ever thought that the stores in the airport selling food, drinks, essentials, and souvenirs are extortionately overpriced, you're right. And these are the people who profit from that. How much you make in this position will vary depending on the nature of the concessions being sold. A souvenir, stand, or convenience store can be a lucrative proposition. Even so, most concessionaires are paid by the hour. Another thing to keep in mind about concessionaires is that they can keep all kinds of hours. Whether you're arriving at Heathrow from LAX at 6 a.m. or you're taking off for Charles de Gaulle Airport from JFK at midnight, you can count on many concessionaires to be selling their wares. So this is a picture of the concessionaire stores that are available in the airports. Next, we'll go to the air traffic controller. So it's pretty hard to imagine a job where the stakes are higher than an air traffic controller. A single slip up can be catastrophic. Thankfully, at the very least, these jobs are paid as such, with the median salary for an air traffic controller in American airports being $82,300. An air traffic controller has to be on a high alert throughout their long working hours. They are typically positioned in an air traffic control tower and have to keep a close watch on and remain in contact with pilots all around the airspace near the airport. That said, unlike other jobs, there is no formal requirement to be an air traffic controller. It is thus one of the highest salaried jobs you can make without a college degree. However, recruitment standards are extremely high, and you'll have to pass a rigorous aptitude test and screening process. So this is the workspace of an air traffic controller. He works in the space and it's up to him to make the decisions during the flight. So next we have the airport engineer. Think of all the little things that have to go right in to keep an airport humming. Now think of these consequences of just one of those things that goes wrong. Airport engineering can lead to massive delays or worse. As such, airport engineers are vital to keeping everything on schedule and all the machinery in good working order. They construct and maintain the main airport structures as well as the takeoff and landing strips. There is heavy amount of research involved in this job. Airport planners often come from civil or structural engineering backgrounds and perform many tests to make sure that the things they build are up to snuff. So they're compensated for the tasks they do by making up to $117,000 in a month. So next we go to airport planner. Airport planners are often the people who come up with the ideas which are then put into practice by the engineers. That said, there is some overlap between the two jobs descriptions and duties. In addition to planning new structures, airport planners can also plan renovation work. With all that planning, it shouldn't surprise you that this is yet another job which involves a heavy amount of research. In addition to looking into the technical side of things, airport planners also have to make sure everything is in accordance with regulations as well. They are also often asked with looking into the long-term consequences of building projects. For example, airport planners can conduct studies to project the long-term impact that airport improvements may have on the surrounding area. An airport planner's salary can range wildly from a low of $40,500 to more experienced planners making as much as $90,000. Next, we come to TSA or TSO airport security members. If you've been through an American airport lately, you know TSA all too well. While airport security members are a fixture of at airports around the world, in the two decades since 9/11, America's airport security measures have stood out worldwide as among the strictest, with TSA overseeing it all. Working these kinds of jobs can mean everything from taking guests through screening procedures to screening their bags to asking security-related questions. Every year, security teams at US airports screen millions of bags. This is another job which does not require a college degree. That said, as you might imagine, with such a sensitive security job, the screening and training to become a TSA or TSO agent are rigorous. For their long hours of work, US airport security members make around $27,500. Next, we come to air marshal. Another facet of airport security is air marshal. These figures often work as plainclothes agents to surveil the airport and sniff out any suspicious or potentially dangerous activity. The undercover nature of their work makes them some of the most important airport-based counter-terrorism agents. Air marshals are the rare personnel who are allowed to carry weapons and are present on some, though not all, flights for added security. The high stakes, high stress nature of their job is well compensated with salaries of $68,700 in the US and 51,700 euros in the UK. Different countries have different processes and requirements for becoming an air marshal. The US devotes the entire federal air marshal service to the task, while in the UK, air marshals serve as part of the Metropolitan Police. Australia airline EIAI, meanwhile, provide their own trained marshals. Next, we come to airframe or power plant mechanic. The electronics onboard an airplane are handled by avionics teams. Airframe or power plant mechanics deal with everything else, from the engine to the brakes to the landing gear and every other major facet of the plane. As you might imagine, working on such large pieces of machinery means having a fair amount of physical strength. It also means having a good knowledge of the complex workings of a plane. You'll thus need to attain a reasonably high level of education. Avionics professionals must be accredited by an official body such as the European Aviation Safety Agency, EASA, or Federal Aviation Administration, FAA. Airframe or power plant mechanics typically must do the same. They are well compensated with an average salary of $52,000 in the US and 39.1 lakh euros in the UK. Next, we come to baggage handlers. So if you've ever arrived at an airport only to find your suitcase is a mangled mess, you know the impact that baggage handlers can have on your flight experience. Hopefully, your experience doesn't have to be a negative one. When baggage handlers do their job well, you hardly notice them at work. However, you can bet that they are all too aware of their work every moment of the day or night. handling is a highly labor-intensive job, often requiring handlers to lift extremely heavy bags. You're also tasked with packing the luggage onto the flight, as well as placing your baggage on the carousel that leads to the baggage pickup area. All of this takes quite a lot of work, for which baggage handlers are paid up to $23,500 on an average. Last, we come to the airline pilots. Last but not the least, what list of airport-based jobs would be complete without the pilots themselves? Pilots can be found at the helm of planes carrying all manner of passengers and cargo traveling all over the world. The training and screening process to become a licensed pilot takes many years. That's due in part to the fact that pilots don't just fly their planes. They also perform pre-flight checks, communicate with air traffic control members to make sure that they are in the clear, adjust flight paths if necessary, and update passengers as to the status of their flight. Pilots can fly for airlines, for private companies, or as personal pilots for entrepreneurs. Depending on the field in which they are working, as well as their experience level, they can make anywhere from $60 to $100,000. All the while traveling all over the world. So these are some of the images that are associated with airports, the interior, the cockpit. So thank you so much for having me. Thank you.